maybe we can get started with one that you probably should recognize.
Oh, I know that one. Yeah, the dodo. That's the dodo from Ice Age, yeah.
That's right. The second one.
You have to help me out on that one.
It's a Disney film from the early 80s. It's kind of a spoof superhero movie.
Yeah, now you I don't know that one.
No, it's Condor Man. Oh, the third one is, I think you probably recognize the movie.
Oh, I know, Chicken Run. Yeah, I know those characters.
You're a fan of stop motion?
I am a big fan of stop motion, yeah.
Is it something you've had
especially a go at? Aardman, yeah. One of my favorite stuff that they've done was a short that they've done with zoo animals, Creature Comforts.
Creature Comforts, yes, with the lip syncing.
Yeah, and it was amazing.
And
the birds.
Hitchcock's The Birds, yes, obviously. Yes. Do you know the beginning of the film, Tippi Hedren goes into a pet shop in San Francisco, I believe, and buys a pair of birds. Do you know what kind of birds they were?
Oh, I don't know that one.
No?
Can I cheat? Can I just...
two birds together rhymes with glove. It's a pair of lovebirds.
Lovebirds, wow.
But here's a good one.
At one point in the genesis of the story, there was one moment in the movie that I wanted, like, Blue, the main character, to actually... this was his favorite movie. And even though, like, we all felt scared about it, they loved it. They cheer for the birds.
I love that. So you didn't think about having Blue and Jewel dive bombing a petrol station at any point. number five, South American.
Oh, yes. That one is from Up. I don't remember the name. I'm terrible with names, but I know that that's a character from Up.
How about this one?
Okay. It looks like Batman, but I don't know. No, it's not Batman.
No. Did you see Watchmen?
No, I did not see Watchmen.
Okay.
Look, I'm.
I know that.
I don't get out much.
I know. So. I'm not meaning to put you on the spot.
Oh, I know that one. That's from. Is it from The Lion King?
Yes.
Yes. I don't know the name, but I know it was a funny character. In terms of animated movies, one of my favorite classics.
So, what would be your ultimate kind of, if you're having a night in, or you're on a desert island, you've got one. One big animation to take that you'd want to watch again.
Can I take two?
Oh, yeah, go on then.
Dumbo and Bambi, maybe?
Yeah. Very cool.
Those two.
Yeah.
Like, I always love those movies.
Last one, and this is really hard.
I know that
one. Do you know this one?
I know the name, but actually, I know his name in Portuguese. I don't know his name in English.
I think it's the same.
Is it Zé Carioca?
No, it's not the same.
So that's not the same. I told you.
I think it's... No, it is. You're right. Absolutely.
Is it?
Yeah, but I can't
pronounce it. Is it something like
Jose...
José Carioca.
Exactly.
Yeah. It's funny because when I start to make this movie, I would say, like, a lot of people say, oh, there was a movie already made with birds in, like, in South America. And I looked at, specifically this movie just to make sure that I didn't make it like that. Because even though I love this movie was felt more like a travelogue. Mm. You know, it's a very charming movie, but it was about South America in general. And I always felt like I wanted to do a movie in Rio. And I wanted to do a movie with birds because I love birds and I was into that. So I was thinking that why not Rio, like such a, city with contrasts, You have forest, you have the city. You have music, you have, nature, samba, you have it all. And that's what kind of the inspiration.
I'm sorry for springing this horrible quiz on you.
No, this is good. This is fun. Now I'm like I need to do my homework.
With your prize.
Thank you. This will come handy in a couple hours.
If you get blood sugar, runs low. Anyway, thanks, Carlos.
Thank you
very much. Enjoy the movie. Good luck with that.
Thanks.